Early on the morning of 3rd October, as I mentioned, U.S. forces accompanied that Nigerian unit on a reconnaissance mission to gather information. The assessment by our leaders on the ground at that time was that contact with the enemy was unlikely. Mid-morning on October 4th, the patrol began to take fire as they were returning to their operating base. Approximately 1 hour after taking fire, the team requested support. And within minutes, a remotely piloted aircraft arrived overhead. Within an hour, French Mirage jets arrived on station. And then later that afternoon, French attack helicopters arrived on station, and a Nigerian quick reaction force arrived in the area where our troops were in contact with the enemy. During a firefight, two U.S. soldiers were wounded and evacuated by French air to Niamey. And that was consistent with the casualty evacuation plan that was in place for this particular operation. Three U.S. soldiers who were killed in action were evacuated on the evening of 4 October, and at that time, Sergeant LaDavid Johnson was still missing. On the evening of 6 October, Sergeant Johnson's body was found and subsequently evacuated. From the time the firefight was initiated until Sergeant Johnson's body was recovered, French, Nigerian, or U.S. forces remained in that area. Now, many of you have asked a number of questions, and those are all, and many of them are fair questions, and we owe you more information. More importantly, we owe the families that have fallen more information, and that's what the investigation is designed to identify. The questions include, did the mission of U.S. forces change during the operation? Did our forces have adequate intelligence, equipment, and training? Was our pre-mission assessment of the threat in the area accurate? How did U.S. forces become separated during the engagement, specifically Sergeant Johnson? And why did it take time to find and recover Sergeant Johnson? Again, these are all fair questions that the investigation is designed to identify. We owe the families as much information as we can find out about what happened. And we owe the American people an explanation of what their men and women were doing at this particular time. When I say that, I mean men and women in harm's way anywhere in the world. They should know what the mission is and what we're trying to accomplish when we're there. And so those are all fair questions in my judgment. I mean, in other words, that's why we're out here today, is to take your questions and provide as much information as we have. The only thing I'm asking for today is a bit of patience to make sure that what we provide to you when we provide it is factual. And the other thing I think that's also important is when this information is finally available, the first thing we're going to do is go visit the families in their homes, should they welcome us. And we will have a team go in of experts, and I've done this personally myself several times, a team of experts go into the family and share with them all the facts that are available as a result of the investigation and give them an opportunity to ask questions. And as soon as we're done with that, we'll come back in here and we'll share exactly that same information that we share with the families. And so when I tell you today, we don't know, it'll be a fair answer. We don't know. And I'll tell you everything we do know definitively, and I'll tell you what the key elements are of the investigation that we hope to find out in the coming weeks. But again, with regard to being transparent, I think we do owe the families and the American people transparency in incidents like this, and we intend to deliver just that.